personal summons from the Scions. This must be important business indeed. Though, if it concerns anything so underhand as an assassination, I fear I can be of little help. You have made your point. It is indeed unsettling to find oneself seated across from an impassive mask. There, would this better please your grace? Or should I address you as Lady Lilara?
Nay, the deception has served its purpose. I am glad to see you found amusement in my little jest, Lord Lolorito, but shall we proceed to the business at hand?
By all means. I must say I am most eager to hear your proposal.
Simply put, I would aid the refugees camped in Thanalan in their efforts to return to Alamigo. The reparations you paid in the wake of your earlier misdemeanors will be used to fund the endeavor, together with the fortune seized from the late Taleji Adeleji's estate. But this plan is not intended to benefit the displaced alone. I would make of this an investment which shall enrich Uldar and Alamigo both. And who better to consult on matters of profit than the wealthiest man in all of Thanalan? I beseech you then, Lord Lolorito, share with us your mercantile wisdom.
Ah! 'Twould seem your grace has matured beyond acts of earnest yet misplaced charity. Pray tell me more. To summarize, in return for facilitating the repatriation of refugees and assisting in the establishment of new industry in Alamigo, you ask that a proportion of all subsequent profits be promised to Uldar. I am impressed, Your Grace. 'Tis an elegant solution, albeit one lacking certain crucial details, specifically which industry and where.
How swiftly you identified the weakness in my plan, just as I knew you would. Your travels have taken you across the length and breadth of Gir Abarnia, and you know the land far better than I. Which of the settlements you visited would best provide a home for our refugees? Which has the greatest potential to flourish, given the appropriate investment?
Yes, a quarry town certainly does carry the potential for profit. At least it would do were it situated anywhere near a lucrative market. It would cost more to transport the materials than they are worth, in my humble opinion. Yes, if a stable trade route can be established between Uldar and Alamigo, then Alagiri would once more become an important waypoint. But while such growth would greatly benefit its current residents, I'm afraid it could sustain little beyond that. That desolate little village on the shore of Loch Seld. I know the Saltree and its products well. The Imperial invasion brought an end to their more widespread distribution. Much to the dismay of many a wealthy gourmand, myself included. Salt has ever been a transformative ingredient. And in this instance, I dare say, it could transform a modicum of effort into a mountain of gill.
The local citizens will need to be consulted, of course. But I trust the East Aldenar Trading Company can be relied upon to provide its assistance in negotiating a mutually beneficial arrangement.
Naturally, Your Grace. I shall dispatch representatives well-versed in the extraction of this white gold and wring every last ounce of profit from its production. The Loch's bounty will contribute to Alamigo's enrichment, whilst easing the burden on the bull's aching shoulders. Just as Your Grace desired.
A deal is struck.